Paroxysmal nocturnal hemoglobinuria, or PNH, is a rare blood disease caused by a fault in the body's blood production line. It affects approximately 1 to 1.5 per million people worldwide. PNH occurs following a mutation in the phosphatidylinositol glycan A, or PIGA gene, within hematopoietic stem cells. This mutation leads to a deficiency of GIP-anchored proteins, CD55 and CD59, on the surface of blood cells. These proteins normally protect red blood cells from immune-mediated destruction. However, in PNH, these proteins' absence makes red blood cells susceptible to hemolysis or ruptures. Membrane attack complex triggers intravascular hemolysis, while C3 biopsinization facilitates extravascular hemolysis. PNH can cause several symptoms, including anemia, blood clots, and fatigue. The current standard treatment for PNH involves monoclonal antibodies such as eculizumab or ravulizumab. These medications target the terminal complement pathway by blocking the C5 protein, significantly reducing hemolysis and thrombotic events, and improving the overall quality of life for PNH patients. Despite these benefits, a substantial number of patients remain anemic on anti-C5 treatment. This is thought to be due to the ongoing activation of extravascular hemolysis mediated by macrophages ingesting C3 fragment-coated red cells. In December 2023, the U.S. Food and Drug Administration approved Iptacopan, marketed as Fabhalta, as the first oral monotherapy for paroxysmal nocturnal hemoglobinuria. Iptacopan specifically targets factor B, a key protein in the alternative complement pathway. By inhibiting factor B, Iptacopan prevents the formation of C3 convertase and the subsequent formation of C5 convertase. This mechanism ultimately reduces hemolysis in PNH patients. The FDA approval of Iptacopan was based on the results of two pivotal clinical trials, APPOINT-PNH and APPLY-PNH. The APPOINT-PNH trial investigated the efficacy of Iptacopan in PNH patients who had not previously received complement inhibitor therapy, including anti-C5 therapies. A significant proportion of patients treated with Iptacopan experienced improvements in hemoglobin levels, without requiring red blood cell transfusions. The APPLY-PNH trial evaluated Iptacopan in PNH patients who had prior experience with C5 inhibitors. Significantly more patients on Iptacopan achieved substantial hemoglobin improvements in the absence of red blood cell transfusion than patients on C5 inhibitors. The most common adverse reactions reported with treatment included headache, nasopharyngitis, or the common cold, viral infection, and rash. Iptacopan carries a risk of serious and life-threatening infections caused by encapsulated bacteria, including Streptococcus pneumoniae, Neisseria meningitidis, and Haemophilus influenza type B. Because of this risk, Iptacopan is only available through a restricted program. Before starting treatment, it is crucial to vaccinate against encapsulated bacteria or get patients on antibacterial drug prophylaxis if vaccinations are not up to date. Iptacopan is contraindicated in individuals with active serious infections. And that's it for today's pharmacology video. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more pharmacology content.